We have seen various types of classifications such as Dobereiner's law of triads, Cook's homologous series, Newland's law of octaves, where the classification of elements are purely based on atomic masses. Do you know there is another classification which is not only based on atomic masses but also on atomic volume? Stay tuned to know the details. Hello students, welcome back. In this video, we are going to learn about Lother Mayer curve. Here, we are going to study about what is this curve, how to identify the elements based on this curve, and what are its limitations. In year 1869, two scientists, a German scientist and a Russian scientist, they worked independently and they came up with the identical classification of elements. Here, the Lother Mayer, a German scientist, and Mendeleev, a Russian scientist. They both worked on periodic properties of elements with their atomic masses. But what is the difference between them? Here, Lother Mayer worked only on the physical properties of elements and he named it as Lother Mayer atomic volume curve. Whereas, Mendeleev have completely focused on the chemical properties of elements and named these as Mendeleev periodic table. Here, in this video, I am going to emphasize on Lother Mayer's curve. So, what is this Lother Mayer curve? Lother Mayer, he has calculated the atomic volumes of all the elements by using this formula, where atomic volume of element is nothing but atomic mass upon density. And then he plotted a graph which is called as Lother Mayer's curve. Lother Mayer plotted a graph by taking atomic masses on x-axis and atomic volume on y-axis. So, when he plotted a graph, he got a curve which consists of sharp peaks and a broad minima. Now, he explained that elements with similar properties occupy similar positions on this curve. For example, here you can see that alkali metals. Alkali metals, they occupied the peaks of the atomic volume curve, which means that alkali metals have largest atomic volume. Similarly, you can say that alkaline earth metals, they occupied the midpoints of the descending positions of these curves. Also, you can understand that halogens, they occupied the ascending portions of this curve. And transition elements have occupied the minimal positions of this curve. So, by this, we can say that elements with similar properties occupy similar positions on this atomic volume curve. So, on this basis or these observations, Lother Mayer proposed that physical properties such as atomic volume, boiling point, melting point or any other physical property of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic masses. Also, if you replace the atomic masses with atomic numbers also, the curves remain same. So, there are certain limitations with this atomic volume curve. Because in practical, this curve is not at all widely used. The only limitation is because we are not able to memorize the exact positions where the elements are going to occupy on this curve. That's the only limitation why this Lother Mayer atomic volume curve is not existed nowadays and why the Mendeleev periodic table has got more importance. In order to summarize what we have seen here, we understood how a Lother Mayer has plotted a curve and why it is called as Lother Mayer's atomic volume curve. Because the x-axis he has considered atomic masses and on the y-axis he has considered the atomic volume. So it is called as atomic volume curve. Also, he explained that alkali metals have occupied the maxima of the curve, alkaline earth metals have occupied the midpoints of the descending portions of the curve, and halogens have occupied the ascending portions of the curve, and transition elements have occupied the minima of the curve. So this is all about the Lother Mayer's curve or Lother Mayer atomic volume curve. Thank you guys.